Mr. Deputy Speaker, cognizant of the purposes of today's proceedings, I do still wish to raise once again the plight of veterans of Operation Banner. I represent many such veterans who live in my constituency, and indeed honourable members right across this House do so as well. While the service was in Northern Ireland, those who served came from right across our United Kingdom and beyond. Mr. Speaker, at the last reading, my colleague, the Honourable Member for Belfast East, and I asked the Minister to state that the provisions of this bill will not become law until the assurances made in this House on the 18th of March regarding Northern Ireland were fulfilled. In the Minister's response, he said, and I quote, "We are clear that we will deliver our commitments to Northern Ireland. In a written ministerial statement on the 18th of March, we committed to equal treatment for those who served on Operation Banner. We will not resign from that position." Good intention, the right intention, but no guarantee. I suspect, indeed, I know from our conversations with veterans that the longer this delay continues, the more suspicious they get. This is wrong, Mr. Speaker. I need to know that the Minister believes this is wrong as well. So what is the delay? Those who await the knock at the door for standing up to terrorism deserve answers, and I urge the Minister to give those answers today. This bill is welcome and it delivers on promises made by the government. But the time for leaving some veterans behind as prey to vexatious prosecutions is wrong, especially if, as suspected, it is for no other reason than a sop to the political front of the very people who killed and maimed many of those they served beside.